The light in here is so beautiful today. I mean, it is on most days, but I don't know, something about it today. Welcome to day 26 of my 365-day vlogging experiment, where I am documenting my business journey in creating an online photography business and growing my personal brand in the health and fitness industry. And apparently, Cilantro was interested to make an appearance today. Thank you for my kisses. Look how he's sitting. Look at him. This is ridiculous. He's ridiculous. The light in here is so beautiful today. I mean, it is on most days, but I don't know, something about it today. I think I'm just excited about the fact that we officially started, and by we, I mean the husband, officially started the remodeling process of this studio space yesterday. All right, and today I've spent pretty much the entire day writing. I'm working on my fitness journey series, and so I've been working on the first three updates for that series, and yesterday I worked on the little intro video for that. So since there isn't too many exciting things to talk about, to me they are, because I've been writing all day, I wanted to take the time today to talk numbers. And by numbers, I mean not financial numbers, but numbers of followers and stats on the internet, and this has to do with growing my personal brand. I basically just want to use today's video as like a before and see what happens throughout the next 365 days as I'm putting into motion these different little projects, putting out more content, connecting with people, and just being more active on my social media platforms and putting in a real effort to produce quality content. So before we get to that though, I just want to make it really clear that I completely understand and get the idea of the number of followers you have is not important. So many business experts talk about that the numbers don't matter, and you shouldn't base your self-worth or the worth of what you're doing on those numbers or the numbers of views. I totally agree with that. I'm completely on board with that. On the flip side though, technically, the numbers do matter. They matter if you're trying to make an income off of producing content, of working with brands, and having an online business. And if you are in the process of growing your personal brand in any industry right now as well, I think you'll understand, or you're kind of get where I'm coming from. So I mean that in the real practical sense of things like, for example, YouTube. I believe, I could be totally wrong in this, but I remember reading something about this a few months ago. So on YouTube, you can't start monetizing your videos unless you have 1,000+ followers. Like I said, I could be totally wrong. I'm not producing content, I'm not making these videos for views, for followers. Like I mentioned the other day, I didn't even expect anybody to be watching these vlogs. But if I ever want to make any type of income from YouTube, then the numbers technically do matter, right? I need to have at least 1,000 followers. Now, that doesn't mean that it's gonna change my approach to things or that I'm gonna focus only on that. Obviously not. I am a creative at heart, and what comes first for me in everything that I'm doing with my online business or with my personal brand is the creative aspect of it, and sometimes that's to a fault. Another example, on Instagram, I believe that you have to have at least 10,000 followers to be able to use the swipe up feature. So in Instagram stories, when you post those, I'm sure you've seen some people have the swipe up feature. You can't get that unless you have 10,000 or more followers on Instagram. So again, I'm not posting pictures of cilantro or beautiful Hawaii landscapes on Instagram because I'm thirsty for all the followers and only focusing on that. No, it's the creative part for me first, but if I want the swipe up feature, which would be awesome to have, I need at least $10,000. That would be fantastic too. 10,000 followers on Instagram first. So again, the numbers do matter to a point. And I know that there are other platforms with different rules as to when you qualify for certain things. Same thing with sponsorships and being able to work with companies or different agencies. I could be totally wrong, but I highly doubt that big brands like Adidas or any of these other big brands working with influencers or online content creators, I highly doubt they are going to be approaching people with 200 followers on Instagram or 50 followers on YouTube. I'm just saying that to a point, the numbers do matter. And for me, that's part of like strategy and the technical aspect of things. I really do believe that a lot of people would still be producing content, would still be doing what they do if they weren't making money off of those things. And I'm positive that I would still be taking pictures of all the things and making videos if making money one day were not an option. And besides, as of now, being a an aspiring content creator is not going to be my main source of income. I mean, that could change. That would be great if it could be one day, but I don't want to do things because of the numbers. I'm probably not making sense of all this, but the point of this video was to look at where I'm at now and see what will happen once I put all of these strategies and ideas into motion. Where will we be 365 days from now? So this is where we're at. On Instagram, as of today, I am at 877 followers. And my stories on Instagram usually get, depending on the day, between 100 to 130 views. And usually if I tag it with a location or if I use a hashtag, they usually get a little bit more views. Now moving on to YouTube. Currently on my YouTube channel, I have 134 subscribers. The only thing I'm currently posting on my YouTube channel is this daily business vlog. Like I've mentioned in previous vlogs, I am working on a complete content strategy to post more videos on my YouTube channel. I'm very excited to see how this number will change or how the views will change. And again, that is not the main objective. I would be doing this either way, even if I couldn't see the number. But because this is a business experiment, this is something that I want to keep track of. The next one is my lifestyle Facebook page. I currently have 1,150 people that like my lifestyle Facebook page. And I haven't posted anything on Facebook since August of 2016. That is not very good. The next one that I want to keep track of is Twitter. Currently on Twitter, I have 431 followers. And for the past couple of weeks, I've been tweeting at least once a day, sometimes two or three times a day. The next one is Snapchat, but honestly, I haven't used that one in such a long time. I'm not even logged in right now because I'm trying to change my username on that. And I think I only have a couple people on there because I just haven't put that much effort into Snapchat. Let's see, what else? Okay, Pinterest. On Pinterest, I currently have 420 followers and I have not pinned anything in a really long time. And since I've had Pinterest, I've never really had a strategy behind the way I use it. So I hope to work on that this year. And then again, we'll see what happens with that. I also have a Musical.ly, Tumblr, and Spotify account, but I don't really do anything with those. Well, Spotify I use to teach my sculpt classes, but I'm not really gonna keep track of those for this video today because I don't really do anything with that. The main ones are Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. I'm really curious to see how these will change over the next year because this is an experiment and I love this kind of stuff. So that's all I have for today. Super simple, but I figured this would probably be more interesting than a time lapse of me like typing at my computer or ranting about something else. Thank you so much for being here. I will see you tomorrow. So he was staying back there and slowly made his way right here. Sneaky little guy, but he's still getting used to this whole vlogging situation and knowing that he can't be playing or shoving his little toys in my face while I'm recording a video.